LSR again, and today is the 15th of April 2019, and guess what, it is one of the last days, not the last day itself yet, to my third year. And I've come a little early before class to just take a few shots of college and just, you know, reminisce. Already, I know. So I'm just sitting here and I'm writing my diary and I'm just thinking about college and just generally. I just can't believe it that it's like the last week of college. And right now, a really nice junior just came up to me and started talking to me. And she said, oh wait, it's your last week. And I'm like, yeah. And this has been happening to me since 2 weeks now, where everyone's reminding us of that fact that we're leaving.
What is your favorite paper? Like Dev Eco?
Do I have an option to say no, none?
Yeah, of course.
My favorite is Dev.
Yeah.
I like development economics because I don't like MFM. That is money and financial markets. I'm going by elimination method, and the remaining papers are environmental economics. That's also good.
I think it's a nice option. It's very
different. In fact, from 3 years, I think development economics is one of my
development eco one was a really nice paper.
So what's your favorite paper?
Right now I'm in the middle of a crisis. It's called the crisis in my closet, clearly.
Okay.
But
it's okay.
As we talk about this, my favorite paper is, I really like Dev Eco this time, like the land and labor chapter. The models were very interesting, and I also really enjoy Indian economy in general, but this semester it's been very technical and to do with data, so I'm not enjoying that. Yeah, Dev Eco is the only paper I like. Environment economics is nice, but the subject itself is very disjointed.
Hello. So we're finally going to Brown Sugar.
Yes.
And we're excited because as a group we've never been there. Not that it's like a super awesome dope place or anything.
I mean, I'm just noticing that it's so common here. I don't think it's an LSR specific thing, but I've seen this a lot in college. Is that people just really warmly compliment each other all the time.
That's true. And I think, I don't know if it's part of being like in an all-women institution, but it's like a way for like women to kind of validate each other and be like, hey girl, you're looking awesome, I love your earrings, and these random compliments, you just randomly get them in the corridors, in the classrooms. And I think that's something even I have noticed. And I love it.
I know, it's so damn sweet.
And it's not like you're putting an extra effort into it, it's just that, like,
random,
I saw the one,
kindness.
I was like, you look nice.
It's such a common norm to like appreciate each other, the effort they
put. Because now it has become normalized.
Yeah.
So everybody is like,
so if any of the random people put in a single effort to maybe look better, even like, hey, you're looking so amazing.
Yeah,
and I wouldn't even call it validation. I just feel like it's like a thing that we just keep uplifting each other, and there's a common misperception outside that people think that in LSR we're trying to always pull each other down, that we're very negative and bitchy, and you know, girls are very jealous in nature.
That's ridiculous.
Competitive and jealous.
I think if there's one thing I've learned in 3 years of LSR, I think people have a strong sense of sisterhood.
That's
people
true,
do have a strong sense of wanting, you know, like the other women around them.
Hey guys, so we're finally
I want to remind you guys to stay hydrated. Uh-huh. It's very important, otherwise you'll die. Otherwise you'll literally
die. You don't say, honey.
Yeah, I know. I don't usually carry a bottle of water, but this is essential now.
Yeah.
Like,
It's the elixir of life.
But so is like coconut water.
Yeah. But we're talking about like our growth curves in school versus college. And we're talking about how our college experience has been. It's truly been a day of reminiscing. And it's already like begun at the group level. And we're talking about things like let's cry in a group. It's like 2:30. And we have a class at 2:30. But we're in GK1 M block. Which is crazy. And we're out and about trying to find autos, but there are like none for some weird reason. So we've stepped on campus and it's like what? I don't know, I think it's 2:50 or something, I'm not so sure. And we're just rushing to class, finally. Let's see our teacher's reaction. I hope it's like... Clock strikes 4:30 and now I'm just heading to the upper seminar room because we have the confrontation for all the candidates for department elections and I'm looking forward to that and I have to make an informed vote. I've gone through the agendas, most of them, there are a few left and I have a few questions as well. I'm that person, guys.
Asking all this information that could work. Amir was already at 14 million hospitality.
How did you find the confrontation and how was it, Shailja, standing for, I mean, how is it feeling?
Experience. I got to talk to a lot of people in the department I had interacted with and I got to know a lot of things about the department that I wasn't aware of, so it was great.
That's great. How do you find a confro?
It's really nice. It's quite amazing. I had a fun time killing people.
Yeah, Mannat was at it. So was I actually. I had
fire in the informal thing also.
Really?
Yeah.
What did you do?
Nothing. I was basically drilling.
It was basically her grilling everybody who was sitting there.
Hello guys, so the confrontation is over. And I'm just like, what time is it? It's like 7 and I'm just leaving college and just speaking to different people and we're almost done with the day, I mean the college day. And yeah.
Wait, Anushka, the president, how did you find the confrontation?
So this was the last event we conducted and I'm like, I want to cry because like my tenure was over and I'm very awkward and I'd like to leave.